Is Microsoft Loop the beginning of the end for OneNote? That is the topic for today's video. But before we jump into the content, just a quick intro. My name is Jonathan from Integral IT in the UK. We help businesses all over the world with the Microsoft 365. Now, a short while ago, I did a video on my channel all about Microsoft OneNote. That's Microsoft's digital note-taking application. But a lot of people said at the time, why are you creating content on OneNote? Microsoft Loop is out now, and Microsoft Loop is going to replace OneNote. Now that's quite interesting, because Microsoft OneNote is now 20 years old. It's older than me. And to be honest, it's looking its age. Lots of different Microsoft applications have been released. They're all modern, they're all cloud-based, and OneNote seems to be lagging behind a bit. Are Microsoft still developing OneNote? Do they still see it as a great application moving forward? Well, what we're going to do today is we're going to look at OneNote and we're going to look at Microsoft Loop. And we're going to ask the question, can Microsoft Loop replace OneNote for you? Now, just before I jump onto the computer behind me and show you OneNote and Loop, just a quick intro on both applications. OneNote is Microsoft's digital note-taking application. You can create notebooks in OneNote. You can have a notebook for recipes, one for your business projects, or just a general notebook. The list goes on. Microsoft Loop, on the other hand, was launched in November 2023 to much fanfare. Now, to be fair to Microsoft, they have never sold Loop as a note-taking application, but it does share some of the features of OneNote, leading people to think, can I replace OneNote with Loop? Now, I think you've listened to me long enough. Let's jump onto that computer behind me and we'll have a demo. So firstly, how do you get hold of Microsoft Loop? Well, it's including your Microsoft 365 subscription. So there's a couple of ways you can access it. You can open a web browser and you can browse simply to loop.microsoft.com. And that will log you in here. You might have to enter your username and password. So there's Loop. Or you can install Loop onto your computer. And if you look down in my taskbar here, you can see that I've got Microsoft Loop installed as an app, and it's exactly the same. To install Loop on your computer, you simply go to the Microsoft Store. So you can just type it in the search there. And in the Microsoft Store, you can simply search for Microsoft Loop. So I'll do that now. And you can see that it's an app that you can choose to install on your computer. Okay, so let's go back to the Loop app, which is installed on my computer, which is here. So this is the Microsoft Loop homepage. I've also got OneNote open here. So this is OneNote, and you OneNote users will be familiar with this. So within OneNote, you've got notebooks. So I've got three notebooks. You're going to think about these as being physical notebooks. I've got a sales one, I've got a marketing one, I've got a YouTube videos one. Within each notebook, you have sections. So again, I've got a couple of sections in this YouTube videos notebook. And then within sections, you have pages. So this is a page, and this is what I would typically do when I'm creating a YouTube video. I'll come into OneNote and I will add a title and I will add some kind of script. So you might recognize this script, and then the screen share. So this is what we're doing now. And these are all the checklists that I want to go through during this screen share. And I've also got a to-do list. So what I've done in OneNote, I have flagged these, as you can see. And what that then does with OneNote is it pushes it through to my to-do. So it becomes part of my to-do list. And you can see here, all these tasks have been published through to Microsoft To-Do. So OneNote is pretty powerful. Plus, at the bottom, I've embedded some videos. This is a bit of a research. So there's some Microsoft videos all about Microsoft Loop, which helps me prepare for this video. So that is OneNote, and that works with notebooks, sections, and pages. So how would this work in Microsoft Loop? With Microsoft Loop, you don't have notebooks. It's not been advertised as a note-taking application. What we do have instead, though, is something called Workspaces. So to replicate what I've got in OneNote, I could create a workspace called YouTube Videos. I'll go in here. I can then choose an icon, something like that. I can choose to share this space on creation, or I can leave that. And at the top, I can update that cover photo if I want. But for now, I'll just click on continue. Now, Loop uses AI to search all of my documents within Microsoft 365. and it will suggest some documents that might be useful for this workspace. I'm not going to choose any of these for now. I'm just going to click on Create Workspace. Now I've got my workspace. So what I could do now is start building this out so it looks like OneNote. So I need a videos and then I need Microsoft Loop as a page. So what I could do is I could call this videos like this. And then what I could do, I could right click here and click on new subpage, and I could call this Microsoft Loop. Okay, so that gives me something that looks like the OneNote. Now at the moment it says just start typing, but you can see underneath if I press the forward slash like that, I get lots of different options. Now if you've ever used a platform like Notion, this is very similar. So at this point I can add lots of different things into here. But to start with, I'm going to add some headings because that's what I've got in my OneNote notebook. So if I go back to OneNote here, I've got title, so I'll add that there. And then underneath has Microsoft. So as you can see, it's enabling to type and take notes just like it would do in OneNote. So what else is in here? Well, we've got the scripts, so I'll add that as a heading. Like that, and I'll just copy and paste everything from here. Okay, that's pretty basic stuff. It's just a text editor. Let's now get a bit more clever. Going back to my document here, I've got something called screen share, and in OneNote, this is a checklist. So can I achieve that in Microsoft Loop? Well, of course I can. I'll firstly add the header, and then what I want to do is press the forward slash and I get all my options, and you can see I've got an option here for checklist. So now what I can do, I can start filling out my checklist. Okay, now I've added all my checklist. So what else can we do in Loop that we can do in OneNote? Well, you can see in my OneNote notebook here, I've got a research section where we can look at embedding videos. So can we do that in Loop as well? You bet you can. So let's start doing another header. Call this the research. I can just highlight that and make that H1. And then I want to embed some videos. So all I'll do is simply copy the URL of the video, and I can copy it from YouTube on Microsoft Stream. So here's a YouTube video here. This is all about Microsoft Loop. So I will copy that here. And you can see that is a YouTube video and that is embedded in there. So that's how you embed videos. So when it comes to notes and creating checklists, you can see that this is a good alternative to OneNote. But there's a couple of advanced things that I want to talk about now that I think might get you excited. If we go back to the OneNote notebook, you can see I've got a to-do list. I think this integration with ToDo is just looks a little bit old-fashioned. So I've got a to-do list. So how will I put that into Microsoft Loop? Well, I'll press the forward slash and I will scroll down and I'll look for something called a task list. Okay, so that's in tasks. I can rename this if I want. I can call this YouTube video, whatever I want. And then I can start entering some tasks. So I will put all these tasks from here into my Loop. Okay, so I've entered all of my tasks in this task list here. So this is where I think the Microsoft Loop tasks are much better than OneNote. So let's start assigning these tasks. I'm going to do a lot of these, obviously, because I'm going to do the filming. So I'll add my name into a lot of these. And then I'll assign a couple of other people to these jobs here. Now, as you can see, once I've added other people, you can see that it says to give this person access and notify them, click on this message. Now, the reason is this Loop page, this workspace, is my own. It's completely private because I've not shared it with anybody else. What I have done, though, is create some tasks within here. And I've assigned them to Olivia and I've assigned them to Simon. But Simon can't see these at the moment. So if I just simply click on here, and then I have to share and notify. Now, what will happen is these two tasks will appear in Olivia and Simon's Microsoft To-Do, which I'm going to show you in a moment. So I'll just put a few dates on here for when we've got to do stuff, just random dates. Okay. Now you can see I've got a little drop down here, task apps. I can open in Planner, I can open in ToDo. So if I now go back to my Microsoft ToDo, okay, and go to planned, because what I've done here is I've put dates on them. So these tasks are now planned. And you can see that these have synced through to my Microsoft ToDo. Okay, so whatever you're doing with Loop, you could have lots of different workspaces, you could have lots of different tasks assigned to you. Everything ends up in your Microsoft ToDo. I think that is really, really clever. Just click on the drop down there. I've also got the other option here to open this in Planner. And you can see I've got a Microsoft Loop plan here. And you can see that that has been added to Planner as well. And you can see all the right people are assigned to those tasks. I can add new buckets. I can do whatever I want. And it's all come from Microsoft Loop. So as you can see, I think this is a definite upgrade on how you create tasks, assign tasks within OneNote. It's definitely better in Microsoft Loop. Now, the next thing I want to talk about, I think, is the true power of Microsoft Loop. And we're going to talk about Loop components. Now, it can be quite tricky to get your head around this. I struggled at first as well. Now, Loop components are like portable building blocks, and you can share them anywhere around your office applications, places like Outlook, Microsoft Teams, which I'm going to show you in a moment. And wherever you share them, they stay in sync. And all the data updates into Microsoft Loop. So the best thing is to show you. So these portable building blocks, if I just come out of this workspace and go back to browse all workspaces, you can see here that workspaces is highlighted here. But we've also got another tab called recent components, and these are the portable building blocks. Now, some of these components are in the YouTube videos, some are in different places. Now, I think it's important that I just launch in and show you. And the first area we're going to look at is how to use Loop components in a Microsoft Teams meeting. So let's head over to Microsoft Teams now. Okay, so I've set this meeting up. It's got a title, it's got Simon I want to invite to it, and it's got a time. And there is just a bit of text there. What you can see here is this here. So it says add an agenda, others can edit. So I'm going to add this agenda now. So this is in the Teams meeting. And as you can see, it's a Loop component. So we will put in here a bit of agenda. Okay, so a bit of an agenda. So I can come in here before the meeting and I can set the meeting up with a Loop component. I've got some meeting notes and some follow-up tasks. But obviously this happens after the meeting, or during the meeting, should I say. So I'll send that invite now. And now I'm going to join this meeting. So I'll join this meeting here. So as you can see here, I am now on a Teams meeting with Simon. We have got the notes section up, and this is our Loop component. You can see SP here, look, he is now starting to fill these notes out. Now, as he continues to do that, if I just hop over to Microsoft Loop and go into here, you can see that there's a new client on board here. And you can see that what Simon is doing in the Teams meeting is actually updating live in Microsoft Loop. Okay, so just go back to the Teams meeting. I can also add things here. And again, if we go back to the Loop, it updates as we go. So everything is synced back in real time into Microsoft Loop. Okay, so that's really good. Now, what I'm going to do now, Simon doesn't know, but I'm just going to cut him off. Okay, bye, Simon. Now, after the meeting is finished, people can come back to it. They can go into recap. And they can see the Microsoft Loop component there. So that is there as well. So I hope you can see the power of that working. Let me show you something else. So we can use Loop components in so many places. I'm now going to use a Loop component in a Teams chat, okay? So this is a Teams message. I'm sending it to Simon and Josh. You can see you can recognize Teams, but what am I going to show you? Well, down here you can see there's a Loop icon here. So I can create this. And I can add a Loop component into my Teams message. So what should I ask? Okay, so let's add a numbered list. What I can do is I can add something like that, and I can send that in the chat. Now you can see SP's initials are here. So Simon now is in this Loop component, and hopefully he's going to come up with some good video ideas. There we go. He's thinking of good ideas. What is the best security baseline? So again, we go back to Loop, we can go back to the homepage, we look at some components, and again, that component is here, and again, it is updating live assignment is typing this out. So again, that is a loop component in Microsoft Teams. What about a loop component in Outlook? Well, let me show you that as well. So I'm here in Outlook and I'm going to send Simon an email. Okay, this is just a bit of fun. We go into here. You can see at the top, there's a loop components. I can add anything in here. I can add a task. I can have a Q&A paragraph, whatever I want to add in here. So let's add a voting table. Call this ideas for business growth. And I'm going to send that to Simon. Now, if I head back to loop again, go to recent components, I've got this here, look. So I can go in. It says where the location is. It's in Outlook. I can go in here. And there you go. Simon is actually updating that as we speak. But as you can see, these are individual components at the moment. So what I can do if I want to, I can add this to my workspace. So I can go like this and I can add that to my workspace. So that's been added. Right, let's go back here. Let's go to YouTube. And again, that is now added, okay? So that is the power of loop components. Right, Simon just needs to stop it now. The demo bit is over, okay? I need to tell him. So if I go back here now, go back to here. So the final thing I want to discuss today is all about sharing, okay? And it all starts from the workspace. So this is a workspace called YouTube Videos. You can see that this has one member and that is me. So I've clicked on there. What I can do if I want to share this, I can share it and I can invite people in. If I do that, it means they will have access to all of this, okay? Everything in here. So that might be a good thing. You might not want to do that. We can also give people access to different things. Like we could share the page link for this Microsoft loop. Or what we can do is share things as components. So we went over that a little bit before. If I go to this entire page, I can click on the top here and I can copy this whole page as a loop component. Then I could go back to Outlook and I could copy that loop component into an email. Now, I don't know why I want to do that, but it's just so I can show you. So the whole page is a loop component. What I can also do, if I just want to say, I might just want to copy this. So I might want someone to add to this. Is there anything else I need to share? So I can just highlight all that. And you can see I can create a loop component with that as well. And with that component, I can dump it into Microsoft applications like Outlook, Teams, or even Whiteboard. Microsoft Loop now integrates with Microsoft Whiteboard. So I hope you've enjoyed this demo of OneNote and Microsoft Loop. What are you thinking? Do you want my honest opinion? I think if you want a digital note-taking application just for your own use, I'd stick with OneNote. But if you're looking to collaborate across multiple Microsoft 365 applications with your entire team, then OneNote won't do that. Microsoft Loop is the way forward. I look forward to seeing you again soon.